As of December 4th of 2023, there are currently 44 volcanoes which are actively erupting around the planet. The newest volcano which joined this erupting list was Indonesia's Marapi volcano on December 3rd, as it sadly produced an unexpected and deadly volcanic eruption. Due to the fact that the initial of the approximately 40 explosions which have since occurred had essentially no warning signs beforehand, the event sadly caused the first direct volcanic casualties of 2023. With this being said, here are this week's major volcano-related news stories. In Papua New Guinea, the extent of damage and destruction caused by the Ulawun volcano's powerful subplanetary eruption on November 20th has only recently become clear, involving more than 10 square kilometers of completely scorched forest. Meanwhile, in Indonesia, the Rinjani volcano in the last 2 days has produced a significantly increased number of low-frequency earthquakes, suggesting that a new magmatic intrusion could be ongoing underneath this volcano. And in what is this week's top story, it appears that ground deformation is ongoing in the Galapagos Islands due to an intrusion of magma at the island chain's highest volcanic peak. What I am referring to is Volcan Wolf on the island of Isabela, which is a 1,710-meter or 5,620-foot-tall shield volcano. Now, before I discuss this story further, I want to clarify that I have not been able to independently verify that there is definitely ground deformation ongoing at the Volcan Wolf shield volcano, although a third-party source seemingly indicated that ground deformation is ongoing. This apparent ground deformation began around November 10th, and since then the summit region of Volcan Wolf and its large caldera has been seemingly uplifted by up to approximately 6 centimeters or 2.4 inches. Although the ground deformation has seemingly slowed in terms of overall rate, magma seems to be pooling at a depth of around 2 kilometers underneath this beautiful shield volcano. Whether this will result in a new volcanic eruption is uncertain, as many intrusions fail without producing an eruption. However, I witnessed a similar episode of ground deformation occur between October of 2021 and very early January of 2022, which was eventually followed by a 3-month-long, moderately explosive volcanic eruption. If Volcan Wolf was to erupt due to its current intrusion, current deformation data suggests it would be smaller in size than the 2022 eruption. Meanwhile, in Indonesia, on the island of Lombok, new volcanic unrest was detected at the Rinjani volcano. While Rinjani today contains a vast 8.3-kilometer-wide caldera and scenic central stratocone, if you were to have been in this very spot in the year 1256, there would have instead been no caldera and a 14,000-foot-tall stratovolcano. Ever since this volcano's climactic eruption in 1257, it has generally produced small to medium-sized explosive eruptions which intermittently expand the Barujari volcanic cone. In the last century, a dozen such eruptions have occurred via its central crater, with the last such eruption occurring in 2016. However, since December 2nd, the number of low-frequency earthquakes has greatly increased, going from 1 on December 1st to 11 on December 2nd and then 29 on December 3rd. This increase suggests two possibilities. Either a deep to moderate depth body of basaltic magma is actively intruding into the volcano and its magma conduit, or an increased pressurization has occurred in its hydrothermal system. These two possibilities suggest an increased possibility of a magmatic and phreatic eruption respectively, which could occur in the next few days to weeks. In Papua New Guinea, it has been 15 days since Ulawun produced a powerful subplanetary eruption which sent a plume of ash to a height of 60,000 feet. While there were no casualties, more than an inch of ash fell across some regions and ruined many local palm oil trees for the season. Luckily, Ulawun's eruptive intensity has greatly decreased since November 20th, and this has allowed us to determine the extent of pyroclastic flows its eruption created. While I previously estimated that pyroclastic flows from that eruption covered about 7.3 square kilometers in this region, in reality it covered 13.7 square kilometers in this region. Ulawun's powerful eruption could have been a one-off event, or it could suggest that more such powerful eruptions will occur in the next few months. Here is a quick list of all the world's volcanoes which are currently erupting. Additionally, here are some volcanoes showing signs of unrest which are not erupting as of the recording of this video on December 4th of 2023. As a final note, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube.